Invite us for holy moments.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to our Holy Mass as we are gathered here on this Tuesday in this week of Lent. May we continue to open our hearts to encounter Him more deeply here at this Holy Mass. And let us begin our prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. My dear brothers and sisters, at this time let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you healed the sick. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you forgave sinners. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you gave yourself to heal us and bring us strength. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. May the venerable exercises of holy devotion shape the hearts of your faithful, O Lord, to welcome worthily the Paschal mystery and proclaim the praises of your salvation. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. The angel brought me, Ezekiel, back to the entrance of the temple of the Lord, and I saw water flowing out from beneath the threshold of the temple toward the east, for the facade of the temple was toward the east. The water flowed down from the right side of the temple, south of the altar. He led me outside the north gate and around to the outer gate facing the east, where I saw water trickling from the right side. Then, when he had walked off to the east with a measuring cord in his hand, he measured off 1,000 cubits and had made me wade through the water, which was ankle deep. He measured off 1,000 and once more had me wade through the water, which was now knee deep. Again, he measured off 1,000 and had me wade. The water was up to my waist. Once more, he measured off 1,000, but there was now a river through which I could not wade, for the water had risen so high it had become a river that could not be crossed except by swimming. He asked me, "Have you seen this, son of man?" Then he brought me to the bank of the river where he had me sit. Along the bank of the river I saw very many trees on both sides. He said to me, "The water flows into the eastern district down upon the Arabah, and empties into the sea, the salt waters, which it makes fresh. Wherever the river flows, every sort of living creature that can multiply shall live, and there shall be abundant fish. For wherever this water comes, the sea shall be made fresh. Along both banks of the river, fruit trees of every kind shall grow. Their leaves shall not fade, nor their fruit fail." Every month they shall bear fresh fruit, for they shall be watered by the flow from the sanctuary. Their fruit shall serve for food, and their leaves for medicine. The word of the Lord. Responsorial Psalm, the response is, the Lord of hosts is with us, our stronghold is the God of Jacob. The Lord of hosts is with us, our stronghold is the God of Jacob. God is our refuge and our strength, an ever-present help in distress. Therefore, we fear not, though the earth be shaken and mountains plunge into the depths of the sea. The Lord of hosts is with us. Our stronghold is the God of Jacob. There is a stream whose runlets gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High. God is in its midst. It shall not be disturbed. God will help it at the break of dawn. The Lord of hosts is with us. Our stronghold is the God of Jacob. The Lord of hosts is with us. Our stronghold is the God of Jacob. Come, behold the deeds of the Lord, the astounding things he has wrought on earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. Our stronghold is the God of Jacob.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. A clean heart create for me, O God. Give me back the joy of your salvation. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. There was a feast of the Jews, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. Now, there is in Jerusalem at the Sheep Gate a pool called in Hebrew Bethesda, with five porticos. In these lay a large number of ill, blind, lame, and crippled. One man was there who had been ill for 38 years. When Jesus saw him lying there and knew that he had been ill for a long time, he said to him, "Do you want to be well?" The sick man answered him, "Sir, I have no one to put me into the pool when the water is stirred up. While I am on my way, someone else gets down there before me." Jesus said to him, "Rise, take up your mat and walk." Immediately the man became well, took up his mat, and walked. Now that day was a Sabbath. So the Jews said to the man who was cured, "It is the Sabbath, and it is not lawful for you to carry your mat." He answered them, "The man who made me well told me, 'Take up your mat and walk.'" They asked him, "Who is the man who told you, 'Take it up and walk?'" The man who was healed did not know who it was, for Jesus had slipped away, since there was a crowd there. After this, Jesus found him in the temple area and said to him, "Look, you are well. Do not sin anymore, so that nothing worse may happen to you." The man went and told the Jews that Jesus was the one who had made him well. Therefore, the Jews began to persecute Jesus because he did this on a Sabbath. The Gospel of the Lord. At St. Patrick's Seminary, which is the seminary I went to up in Menlo Park in the Bay Area, contained one of the most beautiful gems, I believe, I would say, of California, definitely in the Bay Area, which is our main chapel at St. Patrick's. And actually, in my office, when I moved into the Vocations office, I had found the image of the chapel, I think, just kind of tucked away, like over in a corner. And so I took it out and brushed it off, and now it stands right in the middle of my wall, you know, surrounding some of my ordination, you know, parts. And so the chapel itself is just so beautiful. And one of the treasures of that chapel is that there are these 10 stained glass windows that flank the sanctuary. And all the stained glass windows have a certain meaning to them. And it was made very intentionally and very deliberately. So in the stained glass window, you'll see that in the middle, there's this bigger image of a part of Jesus' life. And the right above that stained glass window is a smaller circle that has another image from the Old Testament. And the whole concept behind this is that if we remember from one of last week's scripture passages, Jesus talks about how he didn't come to abolish the old law, but he comes to fulfill. He comes to fulfill it in the new, which is himself. And so in that stained glass window, it's supposed to represent on how he fulfills the old in the actions of himself. It really never ceases to amaze me on when I read scriptures, especially today in our first reading is from the prophet Ezekiel, which we know is from the Old Testament. But if we do a lectio, it is so powerful on how there's a prophecy of Jesus. And Jesus, who is a Jewish man, really understood the old law. And how do we see this? It talks about the temple today. And it talks about how there was water trickling from the right side. My dear friends, in the New Testament, when do we hear about the temple? When does Jesus talk about the temple? He talks about it to the Jews and says, the temple will be destroyed, and in 3 days I will raise it up. He was talking about the temple of himself. And then when we hear about the water flowing out from the right side, again in Ezekiel today, where do we hear water flowing from the right side? Is when he is crucified on this cross, and when he dies. And then the soldier goes up and pierces his side. And what flows from his side? Blood and water. And my dear friends, this represents, one, how he pours out his life to us, that he fulfills the old because he pours out his life. And in that, when he pours out the water and blood from his heart, he purifies us by our baptism. So my dear friends, this Lent, we're called to reflect on this beautiful act on where he gives his life and where water and blood pours out from his side. But also at the same time, we unite ourselves in our reflection during this Lenten season of our own baptism, of our own mission that he has given us. Have we poured out our blood and water from our side for Jesus Christ? Invite us all to please stand. And now, my dear brothers and sisters, let us approach our merciful God with our prayers for our world, for our Holy Father. May God continue to bless him with strength and courage for his worldwide shepherding of souls. Let us pray to the Lord. For all those responsible for public policy, may God guide them in enacting laws that uphold the eternal law of truth given in Christ, and for a culture of life. Let us pray to the Lord. From those suffering from illness of any kind, may the healing and peace of Christ come upon them and give them strength.
Let us pray to the Lord. For people in our faith community who are preparing to be cleansed in the waters of baptism at the Easter Vigil, let us pray to the Lord. For an increase of vocations to the priesthood and religious life, let us pray to the Lord. For our beloved dead, especially for the intention of this Holy Mass, for the repose of the soul of Jim Royston, may they soon experience the joy of eternal life with God. Let us pray to the Lord. And for the special petitions that we hold in the silence of our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord. God of all compassion and mercy, we come to you with complete trust. We ask you to hear and answer our prayers we offer you this day. And through the intercession of Saint Joseph, may we continue to grow in the virtues of faith, hope, and charity. We ask all these things through Christ our Lord. Please be seated.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. We offer to you, O Lord, these gifts which you yourself have bestowed. May they attest to your care as Creator for this our mortal life, and effect in us the healing that brings us immortality. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by your gracious gift each year, your faithful await the sacred Paschal feast with the joy of minds made pure, so that more eagerly intent on prayer and on the works of charity, and participating in the mysteries by which they have been reborn, they may be led to the fullness of grace that you bestow on your sons and daughters. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You, therefore, Almighty Father, we bless through Jesus Christ, your Son, who comes in your name.
He himself is the word that brings salvation, the hand you extend to sinners, the way by which your peace is offered to us. When we ourselves had turned away from you on account of our sins, you brought us back to be reconciled, O Lord, so that converted at last to you, we might love one another through your Son, whom for our sake you handed over to death. And now, celebrating the reconciliation Christ has brought us, we entreat you, sanctify these gifts by the outpouring of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, whose command we fulfill when we celebrate these mysteries. For when about to give his life to set us free, as he reclined at supper, he himself took bread into his hands. And giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, on that same evening, he took the chalice of blessing in his hands, confessing your mercy, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Celebrating, therefore, the memorial of the death and resurrection of your Son, who left us this pledge of his love, we offer you what you have bestowed on us, the sacrifice of perfect reconciliation. Holy Father, we humbly beseech you to accept us also together with your Son, and in the saving banquet, graciously to endow us with his very Spirit, who takes away everything that estranges us from one another. May he make your church a sign of unity and an instrument of your peace among all people. May he keep us in communion with Francis, our Pope, and Kevin, our Bishop, Timothy and Tan, his brother bishops, all the bishops, and your entire people. Just as you have gathered us now at the table of your Son, so also bring us together with the glorious Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed Joseph, her chaste spouse, with your blessed apostles and all the saints, with our brothers and sisters and those of every race and tongue who have died in your friendship. Bring us to share with them the unending banquet of unity in a new heaven and a new earth, where the fullness of your peace will shine forth in Christ Jesus, our Lord.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Glory to the Lord now. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Yeah.
Let us pray. Purify our minds, O Lord, we pray, and renew them with this heavenly sacrament, that we may find help for our bodies now and likewise in times to come. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Per always, we have exposition of the Blessed Sacrament, opportunity for adoration of our great Lord here at the here after the Mass until 12 p.m., ending with the Angelus and benediction. So you're more than welcome to stay to pray with our Lord at this time and spend time in adoration. The Lord be with you. And I invite you to bow down for the blessing. Grant, O merciful God, that your people may remain always devoted to you and may constantly receive from your kindness whatever is for their good. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace. Thanks be to God. Have a great day, everyone. I invite you to kneel at this time for the exposition.
Thank you. Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary,
and she conceived the Holy Spirit.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Behold the handmaid of the Lord.
Be it done unto me according to thy word.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and in the hour of our death. Amen.
And the Word was made flesh. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech thee, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ, thy Son, was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen.
My dear friends, on this day, Tuesday of the fourth week of Lent, we continue to pray for our church, for our parish community, for all members of our faith community here at St. Elizabeth and Seton, that as the one body of Christ, we grow in faith, hope, and charity, and allow ourselves to be blessed and empowered by God through the Holy Spirit. Experience for ourselves the love that we have received from Christ. That love is called to be shared with one another. Let's listen to the reflection, the sermon of Saint Pope Leo the Great, The Virtue of Charity. In the Gospel of John, the Lord says, "In this will all men know that you are my disciples, if you have love for each other." In a letter of the same apostle, we read, "Beloved, let us love one another, for love is from God, and everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. He who does not love does not know God, for God is love. The faithful should therefore enter into themselves and make a true judgment on their attitudes of mind and heart. If they find some store of love's fruit in their heart, they must not doubt God's presence within them. If they would increase their capacity to receive so great a guest, they should practice greater generosity in doing good with persevering charity. If God is love, charity should know no limit, for God cannot be confined. Any time is the right time for works of charity, but these days of Lent provide a special encouragement. Those who want to be present at the Lord's Passover in holiness of mind and body should seek above all to win this grace. For charity contains all other virtues and covers a multitude of sins. As we prepare to celebrate the greatest of all mysteries, by which the blood of Christ did away with our sins, yet let us first of all make ready for the sacrificial offerings of works of mercy. In this way we shall give to those who have sinned against us what God in His goodness has already given to us. Let us now extend to the poor and those afflicted in different ways a more open-handed generosity, so that God may be thanked through many voices in the relief of the needy supported by our fasting. No act of devotion on the part of the faithful gives God more pleasure than that which is lavished on His poor. Where He finds charity with its loving concern, there He recognizes the reflection of His own fatherly care. In these acts of giving, do not fear a lack of means. A generous spirit is itself great wealth. There can be no shortage of material for generosity where it is Christ who feeds and Christ who is fed. In all this activity there is present the hand of Him who multiplies the bread by breaking it and increases it by giving it away. The giver of alms should be free from anxiety and full of joy. His gain will be greatest when he keeps back least for himself. The holy apostle Paul tells us, "He who provides seed for the sower will also provide bread for eating. He will provide you with more seed and will increase the harvest of your goodness. In Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns with the Father and the Holy Spirit forever and ever. Amen." Let us pray. Father, our Creator, you give the world new life by your sacraments. May we, your church, grow in your life and continue to receive your help on earth. Grant this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. We pray for our special indulgence indulgences during this holy year, the Jubilee year of the parish. And we pray through the intercession, the special intercession of our Pope Francis. We pray for the souls in purgatory. We pray for ourselves to be set free from sins and the consequences of sins. And so we sincerely offer to God our prayers. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. The Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born by the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and he is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Prayer of St. Elizabeth and Seton. Lord God, you bless St. Elizabeth and Seton with gifts of grace, as wife and mother, educator and foundress, so that she might spend her life in service to your people. Through her example and prayers, may we learn to express our love for you. In love for our fellow men and women, we ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
Tantum ergo sacramentum veneremus genuis et antiquum documentum novo cedare tui preste fides supplementum sensum defe tui genitori genitoque laus et jubilatio salus on novatus quoque sed et benedictio procedenti ab utroque cum falsi laudatio down in adoration holy, this great sacrament we have of ancient forms of worship, new rite of rest given. Faith will tell us Christ is present when our human senses fail. To to the everlasting Father, and the Son who made us free, and the Spirit God proceeded from them each eternally. May salvation on a blessing, mine and His majesty. Amen. You have given them bread from heaven, having within it all sweet. Lord Jesus Christ, you gave us the Eucharist as a memorial of your suffering and death. May our worship of this sacrament of your body and blood help us experience the salvation you want for us and the peace of the kingdom, where you live with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Blessed be God.
Blessed be His most holy name.
Blessed be
Jesus Christ, true God and true man.
Blessed be
Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be his most sacred heart. Blessed be his most precious blood. Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary, most holy. Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception. Blessed be her glorious assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse. Blessed be God in his angels and in his saints. Blessed be God in his Saint Elizabeth and Seton. Holy God, we praise thy name. Lord of all, we bow before thee. All on earth thy scepter claim. All in heaven above adore thee. Infinite thy vast domain, everlasting is thy reign. Infinite thy vast domain, everlasting is thy reign. Lord of all, we bow before thee. All on earth thy scepter claim. All in heaven above adore thee. Infinite thy vast domain, everlasting is thy reign. Infinite thy vast domain, everlasting is thy reign.
We say thank you to all of those who help us with the adoration hours today.